On the morning of September 8, 1380, at Kulikovo, the Moscow-led Rus army defeated the Mongols for the first time. One of the key battles of the medieval age, it was a transformative event in the rise of Moscow as the future capital of Russia. For the first time, rival principalities had joined Moscow to fight a common enemy. Now, many Rus principalities began to see themselves as one. Future leaders of Moscow would draw on the memory of this battle to claim their supreme political position in Russia. Moscow's Grand Prince, Dmitry Ivanovich, had led the Rus principalities to victory over the Mongols, reinforcing his dominance. But for the Mongols' leadership, the defeat at the Battle of Kulikovo was disastrous. The ruler of their Golden Horde was overthrown by a descendant of Genghis Khan. His name was Toktamish. And Toktamish was not going to let the treacherous Moscow-led Rus get away with rebellion. 2 years after their defeat at Kulikovo, Toktamish's Golden Horde set out to attack Moscow. The city had not felt the wrath of the Mongols for more than a century. That was about to change. Racing to brace the gates of Moscow, Prince Dmitry and his army of Rus allies rushed into the fortified heart of the city. This would be the greatest test of Moscow's mighty stone walls. But could the capital hold out against the furious legion of the Golden Horde? The Muscovites had already faced many Mongol attacks on their city and knew the horde would arrive in vast numbers. The race to fortify Moscow began. Early in his reign, Dmitry had purchased lands surrounding Moscow. These vassal settlements provided Dmitry with taxes paid in gold, but could also supply reinforcements. If Dmitry chose to request reinforcements, he would lose the revenue from that settlement.
Здесь. на добро есть.
Dimitri's call for support was answered by the vassal town, which sent all the troops it could spare. As Dimitri urgently prepared the city's defenses, fleeing villagers from nearby towns flooded into Moscow, desperately seeking refuge from the rapidly approaching Mongol army.
Дело есть. Слушайте. Сделаем сейчас. The refugees from the settlements surrounding Moscow had all arrived at the city. They would wait out the Mongol assault behind Moscow's stone walls.
Чего делать и надо, блядь? Построено будет. Сие мне нравится. Надо есть. Построено есть, ладно. Сделано добро есть. Приуготовляйтесь все. Построено будет. Начну трудитесь. Я построю сие. Наказы будут. Сделаю.
Слуху разумею. Як угодно есть.
Hearing the thunderous beat of the Mongol war drums on the horizon, Dimitri rallied his men to hold their ground. If the stone walls were breached, the city would fall.
Thank you.
Люди здесь суть.
Слушайте все!
Стреляют! Дело худое!
Игорь, выступайте доблесть на войне!
Куда? На месте будем скоро!
Встаньте, воины! Выступайте за следующим показом! Приготовляйтесь и наказы исполните. Идти надо на поскору. Таков наказ есть. Приготовляйтесь, воины! Сидим. Иду, трудитесь в поле. Бать, восстанете, воины! Готовы будет идти надо на поскору. Таков наказ.
Готово есть. Трудитесь.
The Mongol torches made short work of Moscow's wooden palisades. And now, the old stone walls were all that stood between Dmitry and defeat.
Построено крепко есть. Иди, трудницы, надо внесуть.
Исполняйте.
Позиции готовы.
Поведу вы.
Дайте мне рту, да, уже направляюсь. Начинаю строить.
Готовь, если потрудитесь. Сие построю. Приготовляйтесь, воины.
Потрудих все изрядно.
Threat arrived at Moscow's gates. The Mongols rolled in their mightiest siege engines.
Дайте мне работу. Куда направляться? Я построю сие.
With the heartbeat of Mongol war drums closing in, the Rus knew the horde would not relent.
Нас подожаем!
Живу служить. Какой наказ?
Dimitri's call for support was answered by the vassal town, which sent all the troops it could spare. Moscow's mighty stone wall cracked open under the fury of the attack. Dmitry had to expel the enemy immediately or lose his capital and his rule.
Лучницы, как и прикажете,
стрелы многие будут сюда.
Надо пустить.
Ожидайте наказа, лучницы!
Ладницы, на колесах наступайте, ладницы, смели! Служите рад, если...
Служите на наказе!
The Muscovites bravely held their capital in the face of an overwhelming Mongol onslaught. But now an even larger army had arrived on Moscow's doorstep. Running out of time, Dmitry ordered his army to hold back the Mongols long enough for Moscow's citizens to escape. Dmitry's call for support was answered by the vassal town, which sent all the troops it could spare.
Делайте, як велено есть, воїни, напряж по скорбу.
Готово есть, потрудитеся.
Воїни, вкрите, наказ вам есть. Время действовать.
Подскорб, отрада!
Немесо,
сядьте и готовицу!
Никто не жив!
Приготовляйтесь и наказы исполняйте. Ожидайте наказа! Течите, не празднуйте!
Поражаю! надобно по скору. Таков наказ есть.
Dmitri and his men held the city, giving some of Moscow's citizens time to flee. But despite their steadfast defense, the Rus could hold out no longer, and the capital succumbed to the vast numbers of the horde. Toptamish Khan sacked the city, plundering its riches and slaughtering any Muscovites that remained. Prince Dmitri had no choice but to take flight, abandoning his home. Rus independence would have to wait.